This is Rosita Applebaum, and I'm back with a haul. And before you get scared by my appearance, I literally just got out of the shower, number one, so my hair is wet. I have nothing on my face, no makeup. If you follow me on Instagram, you know that my birthday is Saturday. I've been like bombarding Instagram about my birthday. But yes, my birthday is November 1st, so this Saturday I'm turning 22. Some people think I look 32, very strange. I'm 21 right now, so I'll be 22 this Saturday, but my birthday dinner is tomorrow, so I haven't done my nails, I haven't done my hair, like I haven't straightened it, I haven't been wearing makeup, it's been the midterms, I'm sorry that I've been MIA, like I'm really sorry, but priorities really have to come first, and school is first, so I'm really trying to finish college, so I've been really like studying and just going to school. I have class Monday through Saturday, it's really rough on me, and I also work. So yeah, enough with the sob story, I want to show you guys what I got throughout the course of a couple of weeks. Yes, you're gonna judge me because I did get a lot of stuff, but personally, like, it doesn't really matter to me. I work really, really hard. I work two jobs and I get what I want. Like, if I wanna buy something, I'm gonna buy it. I'll be back on my game starting tomorrow. I'll get my eyebrows threaded. I'ma feel brand new, get my eye gel on my nails, and we'll be back to regular programming. I have so many videos that I wanna get for you guys. I didn't do any Halloween videos, I'm sorry. This is the longest intro ever. I talk too much, I know. So I'm gonna get started with the funnest part, which is the Sephora portion. I love Sephora. I literally like live there. I've been ordering like crazy because it was like friends and family discount. I know the VIB starts soon, I think this week or like next week, but there was like a 20% off, and like all of my lovely subbies that work at Sephora were like sending me 20% off coupons, and I'm like, ah, you enablers, I'm buying, like, I just like started ordering like crazy, like one transaction with one item, and then I would just order something else. It was ridiculous, but I'm glad I got these items with the 20% off because I wanted to get them anyway, so thumbs up for that. So I'm gonna get started with Giorgio Armani foundation. I bit the bullet again and I was like regretting returning it or like exchanging it so bad, like it was killing me, and I was like, you know what, I need it back in my life, I'm gonna give it another try, even though I thought it was breaking me out. I don't know if it's breaking me out, I think it was just stress and a lot of other things. So I got it again, and I have the shade 5.75. I've been wearing it ever since I got it. I love it. It's not that dewy. Like, I expected it to be more dewy, but it hasn't really been breaking me out. I'm not sure. Like, I have a little bit of breakouts, but I've been really bad with, like, taking off my makeup because I've just been really tired. But, yep, I got this foundation again, and it's kind of pricey. I think it's, like, $60 or $65. This time around, I'll have links down below to everything. So, yeah. That's that. And then I also picked up another foundation, which is the Estee Lauder Double Wear Stay in Place Makeup, and I have this in the shade Desert Beige, which is 2N1 and standing for neutral. And I don't know if it's just the color, but it didn't look seamless on my skin. Like, you could tell that I had makeup on, which I don't like, but yeah, it's just like this little guy right here. I do want to get a pump for it. I believe the NARS pump fits this. Let me know down below if you own this and have replaced the top with a pump, because this is just like one of those that you just pour out, which really sucks. But I think this was around $40. I'm not really sure, but yeah, I picked that up. Next, I ordered this Laura Mercier Radiance Baked Body Bronzer. And my girl Steph, Glam Overdose, you need to follow her, says she uses this. So I was like, hey girl, why not? So I ordered this. I haven't even looked at it, so I have no idea what it looks like. But it comes in this huge, gigantic box. It's a body bronzer. You can use it on your face, obvi, but this thing is huge. This thing looks like a freaking pancake. I don't even know. I'm so fat, I think about pancakes. Anyways, wow, that is really big. I'm so excited to use this, though. I'm really excited because I want to use it tomorrow, actually. So this thing looks like a brown biscuit pancake, doesn't it? It looks so pretty. I don't even want to swatch it because I feel squeaky clean out the shower. I don't want to have like crazy swatch city on my hands. So we're just gonna have to look at it right here, and I will use it in a tutorial. I think it only comes in one color, so that's the color I got. Next, Stephanie Glam Overdose also influenced me to buy this Guerlain Terracotta Four Seasons Bronzer. I think this was like $76, like completely ridiculous. So ridiculous in so many ways, but I got the 20% off. I think it was like $60 something, and it was free shipping, and she swears by it. Like, she's a bronzer freak, And she was like, I don't know what I've been doing without this bronzer. So I was like, okay, that means it's serious. This thing is so cute. It comes in a little package. I'm probably going to throw this out because I never use these little packages. But, ooh, it's so, like, heavy. I'm so excited to use this tomorrow. I'm really excited. And I got this in the shade Moyen Brunettes because they have a blonde and then they have brunettes and then they have two shades for each. So this is a darker one, so 05 Moyen. And I have not been able to find this at any Sephora in store. I've only found it online. The camera is not doing this justice. It looks like a velvet bronzer. Like, it looks like I can just kind of, like, eat it. Like, it looks like a souffle. I'm so excited for this. Like, you have no idea. I've been, like, dying to film this haul because I want to use this tomorrow and it kills me to like take things out of the package and things like that. So really excited. Let me know if you have this. Let me know if you love it. So yeah. Next, I got the two Bobbi Brown highlights and this is part of their new collection. It doesn't say it on there, but I believe it's Scotch on the Rocks. And there's actually a third highlight, but I got the two that were not shimmer bricks, if that makes any sense. So I got Pink Glow and Bronze Glow. So I ordered Bronze Glow on Sephora.com because that's where they had it first, I think, or where I found it first. And it was free shipping, so I was like, oh, why not? So I first picked up Bronze Glow, and I think this was $55. Girls, let me tell you, this thing is bomb. It is so different than the Becca shades. Like, this is a bronze highlight, like super bronze. It's not like Opal. It's not like the MAC MSS. Like, this is just straight up bronzy gold glitter. Like, it has glitter. You'll see shimmer on your cheeks. And if you don't like that, then not the product for you. But I'm gonna be having a whole highlight video. My idea is to, like, literally put on foundation and then put on a highlight, like one highlight on each cheek, and then take it off and then put it on. I don't know if that's really crazy, but I'm willing to do it for you guys. Like, I'll just use the drugstore foundation and like my skin's probably gonna hate me, but I want to show you guys what the highlight looks on the face, not on my hand. I don't know, let me know what you think. But yeah, Bronze Glow. I actually have used both of these, and if you follow me on Instagram, sometimes occasionally, like, I'll put up my makeup details, and I've worn both of these. I've mentioned both of them. So this one's called Pink Glow, and it's more of a silver glitter, kind of has like pink swirl, but I couldn't choose between the both, so I picked both. If I had to tell you to pick one, I'd probably say Bronze Glow. I don't know, it's really hard because I love Pink Glow too. Don't make me do that, okay, girls? Just, if you could get both, get both. If you're darker skin, maybe just get the Bronze Glow. If you already have so many bronzy colors, try the Pink Glow. I don't know, whatever. Next, I got the Estee Lauder Heat Wave. Oh my god, this has been a long time coming. Like, I've been obsessing over this. My boyfriend literally was like, oh my god, like, stop talking about it. Because I just wouldn't stop talking about this product. I wanted it. It was sold out. Not sold out. This product was limited edition. It's by Estee Lauder. It's called Heat Wave. And it's their illuminating powder jelly. So it was from like seasons ago, and literally this thing goes for like $150 on Amazon, which is absolutely insane. But one of my lovely subbies emailed me saying that she was selling hers and she would sell it to me for a reasonable price, and I was like, ah, the heavens have opened. So that is Heat Wave, and I will include it in my highlight video because it's definitely one of my top favorites. It's a gold color, like straight up gold. I can't explain it. It's just like velvet. It's just such a nice texture. So I really like this. It's not too powdery. It's like a jelly. So love that. And I always saw Emreezy use it, although she doesn't really use it that much anymore. But I have been loving that one probably more than my Becca ones lately. I don't know. I like both. So as you can tell, I've been like on a highlight kick. Like, I just love highlighted skin. I think it just works for me. Like, I don't really like a matte face. It just doesn't go with my skin tone. I don't know. But I got another highlight, and this is Urban Decay Naked Illuminated, and this is in the shade Luminous. This is like a straight up glitter ball. Like, it's a disco in a powder. It's so glittery. You will put this on and it will like stick to you and everyone else that you hug. I love glitter. I'm super like fairy, love glitter, girly. So this is right up my alley. I've used it on my face, but I really love using it on my chest. It gives me like a nice wet look. So I've been loving this, and it's so gigantic. Like, I don't know, it just looks so cute sitting in your makeup collections. So I picked that up. And then another highlight, because hey, what's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? I literally got so much highlights. There's actually another one. But this one is the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector in Opal, but this is the liquid form, and this is a baby version of it. I think this was only like $12 or $15, so I just wanted to give it a try. I've mixed it with my foundation. I liked it. I want to just use it as a highlight though, because when I mixed it, it was just too dewy everywhere. So if you're a dry skin girl, then this is gonna be heaven for you. It's a mix with your foundation, but not for me. So I wanna just give this another try, like on my cheeks, and I don't know, maybe just use less of it. I don't know, I kinda have to work with it a little more, but I do like it. It's a beautiful color. It's opal. If you own Becca Opal in the powder, girl, you know you need that too. Then today in Sephora, I was just like walking by and I was like, I wanna go use some of my points. I had like, I don't know, 1700 points. And I was like, oh, Smashbox Studio Faves. Hello, I want it. And it comes with a little baby full exposure mascara. I'm not gonna open this because it's like crazy, but it's a little mascara. It comes with a little like eyeshadow, like a gold and a brown tone, a nice, really pretty like reddish pink color, or as it looks on the box. The Photo Finish Foundation Primer, which is oil-free, and then the Photo Finish Hydrating Under Eye Primer. I was hoping that it would include the eye primer, because a lot of you girls said you use it, the 24-hour one, but it didn't. But it was 500 points, and I had points to use, and I feel like I never, like, spend my points, so I always spend them on 100-point perks. So I was like, oh, why not? Let me get this cute little, it comes in a little box, and yeah. I don't own too many Smashbox products, except I did order the Full Exposure Mascara. Should be coming in tomorrow because I'm a psycho, with the NARS Eye Primer. That was the last of my ordering of Sephora, okay? I promise. But yeah, I just wanted to use the coupon one more time, 20% off, and I just needed a new mascara. And a lot of girls love Smashbox Full Exposure, so I gave it a try. Oh, wait. And in Sephora, I got another beauty blender because, I don't know, there's something about using a new beauty blender that just makes your foundation and your makeup look like flawless. Like tomorrow for my birthday dinner, I just want to crack this open. It's like crack, literally. And I just want to use it because I'm gonna feel better about it. I don't know, am I crazy? Or do you guys do that? Like, do you guys wait till like a big event to like open up a product? Or is it just me? Maybe it's just me. And then I got another 100 point perk. It's just this little cute little sample of perfume, so I got that as a 100 point perk. And then I got a whole bunch of like perfume freebies, like Gucci Guilty for Men, Prada Candy, Mason Martin Margiela replica beach walk. I got a whole bunch of like little baby perfume samples, which I like to carry in my makeup bag because I don't know, I like to spray it in my makeup bag and in my purse because I'm just crazy like that. So I got a whole bunch of free samples when I ordered the stuff online. And then last but not least, from Sephora, I got the Becca Damselfly Mineral Blush. And I was expecting this to be bigger. It just looks so tiny to me. I was expecting it to be the size of the highlight. I don't know, just something about a small pan for blush, it bothers me. Although the MAC one is small too, because the Becca is so flat, like, it just makes it look smaller. You get 0.2 ounces of product, and it's a really pigmented blush. You really don't need a lot, but I don't know. I was kind of disappointed in the size, but the color is gorgeous. Amazing. I saw Amanda Ensign use it, and I'm such a follower that I went and bought it. And also my girl Marie and Melina, they use it, so I had to give it a try, and I really do love it. So that's what I got from Sephora. Oh, and I forgot to mention the pink glow I got from Nordstrom.com, because they don't have that at Sephora. I believe Barney's also carries it, and Neiman Marcus and Lord & Taylor, but I got mine on Nordstrom.com because Nordstrom.com has free shipping, and I'm always ordering on Nordstrom because, I don't know, they always have things in stock. It's weird. Next, MAC. I ordered three products. The first product I got was MAC Margin Blush. So that's MAC Margin. Don't judge my nails. Warm Soul is more of a like rosy, like dusty rose, where this is more of like an apricot color to me. It's dusty, but it's like a dusty apricot, like almost peachy, but I love both, but I picked that up. And then I also wanted to try the MAC 35 Lashes, number 35 Lashes, because everybody seems to love these. I personally didn't really like them that much. So these are the MAC 35 Lashes. Something weird about them is that they're kind of brown. I don't know if it's just like me, but I hate brown lashes. Like, I don't know. Yeah, they're more natural, but like, if you're already wearing fake lashes, like, girl, just wear like the full black. I don't know. They're a little weird. They're a little hairy. I ordered two of them. I wore one out, and every time I took a picture of my makeup, it didn't give me that like lash effect. It just looked too natural for me. So this is good for like every day or like work or something, but not for like going to the club because it's not going to show up in pictures, and that's first little problem. Next, at MAC, I got the Plush Glass. Yeah, Plush Glass. I was going to say Plump Glass. In Ample Pink. I've worn this. I'm obsessed with this. This is new favorite. Like, you need this. If you don't have Ample Pink, girl, go to MACcosmetics.com and order it. I'm not exaggerating. This is the perfect color. I don't know if it's just for my skin tone, but alone, over nude, over anything, Mwah, amazing. I love it. I love it. It's great. And it's also plumping, so it makes your lips look a little full. So on Nordstrom.com, I ordered the YSL Beige Tribute Lipstick, which I've also put a dent into. I've worn quite a lot of it. I know Samantha uses it, and it's just like the perfect nude. Check out my Instagram for pictures. I know my Instagram's private right now. I don't want to get into it. Like, maybe I'll do an update video, but if I denied you for any reason and you are one of my subscribers, please just send me an email. Please don't, like, judge me if I by accident ignored or, like, denied your request. I'm just going through a lot, and I just need to filter my Instagram. So, it's a lot. It's a lot to deal with, but please just email me. Tell me your Instagram. Don't take it personal. Don't take it the wrong way or the hard way. Just tell me, look, girl, I'm one of your subscribers. I don't have a picture as my profile, or I don't have any pictures, but I am legit. Like, I'm really your subby, so I will definitely go and find you and then accept it. Just bear with me for right now. My Instagram is private for many reasons, but I'm not going to get into that. Next, I went to Target one late night, which is bad, and I was already feeling all types of ways, so that's already bad news. I picked up this cute makeup bag. Like, tell me this isn't so cute. And I think it was only like $10 or $15, which is bananas. It's really big. Like, the shape of it is long, so it's kind of awkward for like everyday use, but it's great for like a weekend. Like, I was in Pennsylvania and I brought like all of my makeup, like the things that I use that I need in here, because it really like expands. It even has a zipper on the inside. It's by Sonia Kashuk. I just love the contrast with the colors, so I really have been enjoying this. And I wish it was a little bit smaller so I could use it for like every day. They do have other sizes, but I just didn't like those. So I got this long one, and I think, again, it was like 10 or 15 bucks. I was on a Sonia Kashuk like binge. I picked up the Rich Bronze Undetectable Cream Bronzer, which a lot of you girls were saying to pick up, and so I did. Picked it up. It's a cream bronzer. It's dark. I don't know how I like it. Maybe I just need to experiment with different brushes. When I applied it, I feel like it was like rubbing off or wasn't like staying all day like my other bronzers. But maybe I just have to set it with a bronzer on top. But I'm pretty sure I did. But I'm rambling. But yeah, picked this cream bronzer. And again, the shade is 42 Rich Bronze. I think there's only two shades. This is the darker one. Got that. Then I picked up three Sonia Kashuk brushes. The first one is the pointed blending brush. And I've actually used it already, of course. I used it in my crease, but then I also like cleaned it and then used it to set my under eye, because I've heard that it's good for both. So it just looks like this. It's a nice blending brush. I wouldn't say it's good for like airbrushing your eyeshadow out, like, you know, really blending it. This is more of like a place crease kind of brush. But I really liked it also for the under eye, because it's really small and it just got right in there and it looked really nice with the well-rested powder. So I got that. Then I got the number 29 brush, which is the black handle one. And this is their blush brush. And I love this. This thing is amazing. It literally just hits the points that you need it to hit. I asked you guys what brush I should get from Sonia Kashuk that was good for blush, and you guys didn't steer me wrong. I thank you, because I love it. And another brush that I got is the synthetic buffing brush, and mine is wet right now because I wash my brushes for tomorrow so that they can be nice and clean and I can have my makeup on points. But yeah, it's just like this brush, and I used it to apply my foundation. It's kind of like a rounded brush. It's not flat, but it was flawless. I loved how it looked. So I really love this to apply my foundation, and I also kind of applied my bronzer with it because I like to like multitask my brushes. I like to do two, three things with one brush, even though I have many brushes. I could probably use one brush for like every inch of my face. But anyway, then I picked up the Maybelline Dream Wonder Fluid Touch Foundation. A beauty on Instagram told me about this and I had to get it. She like DM'd me saying like, I need it in my life, and she's absolutely gorgeous. So I was like, all right, girl, I'm gonna do whatever you say. Like, I'm gonna buy it. So I went out and bought it. I got medium buff, which I haven't actually worn this yet. I saw It's Judy Time did a review on it, and I feel like she's like a drugstore foundation like queen. But I usually don't like drugstore foundations, but I want to buy more just so I can give you guys other options. I know you guys don't want to just buy new $70 foundations every time one comes out, so I want to buy more drugstore ones so I can give you guys like alternative options. Even though I really don't like drugstore foundation, I'm gonna do it for you, girl. I'm gonna take the plunge. Also at Target, I picked up these thank you cards and these little like blank note cards with envelopes. I'm probably gonna use these for tomorrow's dinner, so I'm gonna have to buy more because I need to like write all of you guys back. You guys have been writing to me and I'm just like crying and stuff, like reading them, and I just don't have a chance to write back. But I will write back, and I think those are too small to write back to you guys, so I'm gonna have to just get paper from like Michael's. And at Target, I also picked up this Neutrogena Acne Stress Control Triple Action Toner. I currently don't have a toner in my regimen, so I figured why not. Stephanie also uses this, she loves it, and it has salicylic acid and it treats acne before it emerges. So I'm really excited because I'm trying all these like products out. I really want to like deep clean my face after I like clean it, you know what I mean, just like really get into my pores and clean it. Then Morph sent me their new brushes, which look awesome. I'm so excited to actually like use them. I've been like hoarding them here, but they're just like these ones that have like a metallic kind of handle, and so soft. I love Morph brushes. I especially love their face brushes, like their blush and powder brushes. They also have great like blending brushes. So I'm really excited to try these. So I'm gonna be like unpacking these and actually using them tomorrow and this week. And then they sent me a whole bunch of palettes. Well, three. To me, it's a whole bunch. It's like more makeup than I'll ever need in my life. But it's okay. I just use it on my clients and I have an excuse to get more. They gave me this really pretty, unique blush palette, which has like so many like highly pigmented colors. Like, holy macro, this is crazy pigments. Like, crazy pigments. But I'm really excited to try them out. I think with a light hand, these are going to be gorgeous. I love adding like a pop of pink of blush on top of like, you know, like a dusty pink, just to give it like a pop. Then they sent me this 35 color one, which looks awesome. I feel like I'm missing on Halloween tutorials because like seriously, like look at the colors here. Like this is perfect for Halloween. Like, I mean for every day too, but you got like some really vibrant colors, a beautiful white. So I love these Morphe shadows. They're really inexpensive and really pigmented. I need to wear more color. I know, girl. I just want to just like start over my YouTube, honestly, because I have so much like looks that I want to do. It's impossible. It's just crazy. This one's a 35U palette. I don't know what the U stands for, but these are like shimmery colors. So they're also really vibrant. And I can't wait to use like this color in this one. And there's like gorgeous looks, like so many looks. Like I feel like I'm cheating you guys because I have all these like beautiful products, and I know like another girl would have already like created 100 looks with this, but that's okay. I'll get to it, I promise. Next, I went to European Wax Center today for a Brazilian, TMI possibly, but this is gonna be extra TMI. I picked up this ingrown hair serum, real cute, right? It's Dump the Bumps. It says it eliminates, treats, and prevents ingrown hairs and razor bumps. Calming and soothing exfoliating formula infused with antioxidants, vitamin E, and lavender and tea tree oils. She uses on my bikini area after, and it felt amazing. And I like did a quick just like Google search to see if anybody liked it, and two people, like the first reviews I saw, loved it. So I was like, eh, why not? It was like $25, so I picked it up, and I'm excited to see if it actually works. So then in Rite Aid, I picked up the L'Oreal Collection Exclusive by JLo. This is Jennifer's Nude. And I'm pretty sure this is Ferris Nude in a black matte package. But a lot of you girls are like, pick it up, pick it up. So I'm like, alright, fine, I'll pick it up. But I'm pretty sure it's Ferris Nude. If you guys know me, you know I used to like swear by L'Oreal Ferris Nude. I still love it, but I don't currently have like a new one, so it looks pretty identical. I'll probably wear it in a video so you guys can see what it looks like on. I'm sorry I'm not like swatching and stuff, but I just wanted to show you what I got. Like, this is just a haul. I don't want to like do like try-ons and things like that, but so pretty the package, right? It's a new limited edition package from L'Oreal. So there's like five different shades. There's like Frida, Eva, J.Lo, and a couple other girls, so got that. Then I picked up two of these Clairol Natural Blue Black Nice and Easy hair dyes. I actually used one today, so I did just dye my hair in the shower, so I'm letting it air dry and I'm not putting heat on it because I just want to let it breathe for tonight. But yeah, I used one today, and I picked up two because it was like 2 for $14 or something, and I thought I was gonna need two, but then I was like, my hair is already pretty black, I just wanted to touch up my roots because they get brown. This is the hair dye that I use. I get so many questions on it. It's the Nice and Easy non-foaming version. The foam just doesn't do it for me. This thing lasts so long. My hair grows really, really fast, so I always have to dye my roots and my hair because my hair just grows like a freaking Amazonian princess. But, not a bad thing. But yeah, I got a hair dye. I'm like talking about 10 minutes about a hair dye. It's ridiculous. It's redonkulous, actually. The next portion is, Bath & Body Works. I picked up six hand soaps because they were 6 for $24 and I was like, yeah, why not? So the first one I picked up, and by the way, I always get the gentle foaming. I don't get the hard cleaning one because, I don't know, this is just softer and it leaves my hands nice. The first one I got is called Honolulu Sun and it's Island Coconut and Pacific Palm. And this smells like a tanning lotion. It literally smells like a tanning bed. If you go to Beach Bum and you use like any tanning lotion, this is it right here in a soap. So that's a coconut one. Then I got Fresh Sparkling Snow, which is freshly fallen snow sparkling in sunlight, whatever that smells like. How do you smell like snow? It smells like clean, like bubble bath. This smells like a bubble bath, like an old school bubble bath. So that's that. And then I got Caribbean Escape, which is pineapple, cassava, melon, and creamy coconut. Apparently, I need a vacation because I'm over here with a coconut and Caribbean theme over here, but this smells like a fruity alcohol drink, like one that you order and then it literally has no alcohol in it. That's what that smells like. Don't you just love my descriptions? Then I got Iced Blackberries, which is heirloom blackberries sparkling with white ginger. Let's see. And I love the new bottles. They're like cute. They're shaped nice. This one smells like berries. Just berries. Red berries, blackberries, blueberries, like all mixed together. And yeah, I love this. So that's that. Then I picked up Winter Cranberry, which is frosted cranberries sprinkled with iced peach. That sounds so edible and good. Like, I want to eat these or drink these. This one smells really good, which is Winter Cranberry. Need this one. Smells like cranberry, but just like girly cranberry, like fruity, nice, pretty one. And then I got Sweet Pea, which actually I didn't mean to get. I thought I was picking something else up, but I got Sweet Pea, and I don't really, it's so like typical. Nah, it's okay. I'm not a fan. This one, Japanese cherry blossom, I'm like, nah, but whatever. We needed soap in my house, so picked up a whole bunch of soap. Like, I'm not gonna run out of soap for a while. And I got the French Lavender and Honey Ultra Shea Body Cream 24-Hour Moisture. This smells so amazing. It's definitely going to be my favorite. Every time I put this on, people are like, what is that? I'm like, oh, I know, girl, it's good. It's French Lavender, Lily of the Valley, Nectarine de Provence, Sun-Kissed Honey, White Oak Musk. Amazing. I literally wanted to get this in everything that they had it in. Literally. So, so good. It just smells amazing, and you need it in your life. French. I don't know if it's like permanent. I think it's like it's the signature collection, whatever that means. I'm not like a Bath & Body Works freak, although it kind of looks like it right now. I'm not up on the collections. Then I got this really cute candle holder. Isn't it so cute? It's like glittery. The one I have is like leaves, and I just wanted to get like an icicle-y one for like the Christmas season and Thanksgiving and just the winter months. So I picked one of these up, and I think this was like $9. So, of course, I got a candle holder. I had to get some candles. The first one I picked up is Bergamot Woods. Like, I like this, like, dark candle bottle thing, container. Smells like sexy man. Smells like cologne. It smells amazing. It's like, I only like musky, manly scents, so this is right up my alley. So I picked up Bergamot Woods. Then I picked up Tailgate, which was so cute because it's like a football one. And it says it's a capture all the fun of tailgating on a fall afternoon in a blend of dark cedarwood, sage, and a touch of soft musk. Of course, musky, right up my alley. Supposedly you smell the top to like really smell it. This smells like cologne. Like straight up makes me think of my dad in a non-weird way. Oh my god. Smells like Chanel de Bleu. If you have a husband or a boyfriend or a father or an uncle or anyone who you've given Chanel Blue to and you love the scent, girl, pick you up Tailgate, okay? It smells so good. Your boyfriend's gonna walk into your house like, who the hell has been in my house? You'll be like, I promise, Rosita told me it's the candle I needed. Don't get in trouble, okay, guys? Next is Autumn Sky, and this is, Experience fall's bright, crisp sky with notes of still green leaves, cedar, and lemon wood. This cedar, man, always gets me. Mmm. This is also very manly, but it's a more like fresh, just like exactly it says, autumn sky, very fresh, clean. Smells like you're going on a trip to like a old high school. I don't know, it just smells so manly. I love it. So I'm so excited to burn these. Got two wallflowers and I fell in love with the scent. I'm so sad that they don't have it in anything else, or I think they had it in like a body spray, which I don't use. Cashmere Glow. Oh my lord, this smells amazing. Like, I was so upset. Like, literally I was like, you sure you don't have it in anything else? You sure you don't have it in a lotion? She's like, no, it's vanilla and golden peach layered with luxurious cashmere musk. Girls need this. If you have wallflowers, pick you up some Cashmere Glow. I'm telling you, you're not gonna be disappointed. It smells amazing and these last forever and they're so strong, and I love these wallflowers. They really just freshen up your bathroom and your room. Really great. And I got these two little freebies. Actually, I did get the Cashmere Glow in a body lotion and body wash. Why am I? Oh, they didn't have it in big form, like a bigger form. They only had it in these like mini ones. So I got the mini shower gel and then the mini body lotion. And again, this smells so good. It smells like vanilla. It smells like vanilla, but like a more like golden vanilla. Is that weird? But it smells really good. So I got two little freebies and cute, so I can travel with that. Last but not least, from Bath & Body Works, I got a room spray. This is mahogany teak wood. And I remember one time I made a video and I said Mohegan teak wood. Thumbs up if you have been watching me that long that you remember that video where I'm like, Mohegan teak wood. And I'm like talking about Mohegan teak wood. It's mahogany, okay? And it smells like Abercrombie. It smells like men. It smells like cologne. Right up my alley. Love me some cologne. Okay, so back to makeup. On Holt Look, I got me a Kate Somerville Exfolicate, which is such a cute name. It's like a mask. It's an acne treatment. I've used it and I loved it. I used it like 2 nights ago and it left me so buttery soft. So I got this on Holt Look. I'll leave my Holt Look link down below. I love Holt Look. I think I got this for like $15 when it's like, I don't know, 30 or 40. I don't even know. You can get this at Sephora, but get you a sample of this. It's really strong, but I really like it. It didn't irritate my skin, but it really just worked. Like, I feel like it made my breakouts like just really calm. So again, this is called the Exfolicate and I got it on Holt Look. It's a flash sale website. There's always like so much sales. I just picked up like a whole bunch of Laura Geller stuff, like crazy. So I'm gonna be waiting for that in the mail, stalking the mailman for that. And Gerard Cosmetics sent me their two newest colors that actually haven't even launched yet. And I can't tell you the names, but I'm gonna show you the colors. The first one is this nude and it's from Jaclyn Hill. And if you know the name of it, don't write it, please. Let's keep the fun going. It's a really pretty nudey pink and I'm so excited for you guys to see it on. I still have to do my Gerard Cosmetics lip swatch video. Girl, the list of videos goes on with me. But then this next one, I was about to read you the name, is this like dark color, perfect. Like, my boyfriend saw this and he was like, that is, those colors are, you're gonna love them. He's so cute. He's like, you're gonna love those colors. I'm like, really? Because he opened it for me and I was like, oh my god, you're right, I love them. Nude and like burgundy dark color, amazing and so cute. I love them. And I do have a discount code, 25% off, Rosita Applebaum. I'll leave it down below. And yeah, that's what I got there. I know this video is all over the place, but I also picked up the Mega Pro palette from Lorac. I got it on Lorac's website. Like, I stalked the website when it went live and I was able to get it really fast. I know a lot of people weren't able to get it, but it's this gigantic Lorac Pro palette. It does have some of the colors that the 1 and 2 have. Example, cream, white, I think vanilla, espresso, black. Like, those are in the palettes that already come. But there's these new shades like sepia, dusty plum, orchid, mulberry, merlot, apricot, blush, sienna. I'm like naming you them like as if you can see them, but you can just kind of picture them. Like mulberry, like that's an amazing name for a color. I don't know, is it just me? But this is the Lorac Pro palette. No, the Mega palette. Mega palette. I also get this gigantic mirror on the other side, which is awesome. So love the palette. If we could get this video liked, I will do a get ready with me birthday dinner video tomorrow and I'll probably be using some of the colors from here. Yeah, so that's what I got from LoracCosmetics.com. And And last but not least, I wanted to treat myself since it is my birthday week, weekend, month. I got me my iPhone 6, finally. So I got me the 128 gold, and I do have like a clear case on it that I got from AT&T. I got it from the AT&T store, which is crap. I hate this case. It's so thin, and it's not like my other cases that I get, but I'm waiting for InCase to come out with one, but it's okay for now. But yep, I got me a 6, and I'm going to be doing a what's in my iPhone video very soon. I just need to clean out my phone, delete unnecessary apps, you know, get my background right and everything like that. So yep, my new baby 128. I'm really happy that I have it because the camera is bomb.com on the 6. So I did have a 5S before. I know, don't judge me. I traded it in, so I got like a $300 credit for it. I ended up only paying like $175 for this one, which I know I'm saying only, but it's a 128 gigabyte phone. Like, that's a lot of space. But knowing me with my selfies and my pictures of food and dogs and everything else, probably fill up real quick. So that was the whole haul. I know it was a lot. Girl, trust me, don't try to add up the cost because it's scary, I know. But so I hope you didn't mind my real self here and my no makeup self. And this is just me, raw, uncut, brows heavy, you know what I mean? No cute outfit on, just straight up 11:40 at night. I have class in the morning and I have to do a million bajillion things tomorrow. So I'm gonna go and edit this. Thumbs up this video if you want to see a birthday vlog. I'm going to try to vlog or have someone vlog me at my birthday dinner. I don't know who, but I'm going to try. And also thumbs up if you want to have a second channel with like a vlog every week. I've been thinking about it with a special guest that we might have some vlogs coming up. So I'm definitely doing like Vlogtember, like the vlogging in December, definitely. And I want to do some in November, so yeah, let me know what you think. Please thumbs up this video. It really helps. And yeah, I love you guys so, so much. Bye, guys. Really like Dewey. Girl, I don't really own too many Smashbox. This is a real deal. This is Rose. This is not Rosita. Shh. Sephora is my baby. And then, I doubt you guys want to see that I picked up a little Advil because I was like freaking out for the wax. Even though I've gotten wax before, I just was like trying a new place. Anyway, natural blue black. Oh, it's just gonna come out. What I thought about this, I was like, it smells like my tanning bed. And she looked at me like, you idiot. Like, why are you so like ditzy? But I promise, it just smells like a tanning bed. But